this morning. I'm a throat lozenge sitting on a copy of Tropic of Cancer. The only thing weird about it is that a year ago I never thought I'd paint anything again. I decided I wasn't gonna ever paint again. It didn't bother me too much. Warhol's dead, David Hockney's still alive, I don't need to paint. I've painted over 10,000 paintings. Sad ones, funny ones, dark ones, and light ones. I've done haystacks and rich old ladies by their pools wearing nothing but a scarf. I've painted everything there was to paint. Now it was time to sit back, give interviews, get on the internet, hang out at Club Med, take stock of what I'd done. You know, the best friend I ever had was a dog. That sounds like a cliche unless it's happened to you. Some days that dog was the only reason I even got out of bed. That dog went everywhere with me. Then I heard the crack addicts were stealing dogs and selling them for animal research. Sounded like an urban myth to me, like the mouse in the Coke bottle, but I started leaving her at home after that. You know, Paula was my wife for a while. She ran off to Paris with the great-grandson of Van Gogh, the cartoonist who did fashion graphics for Le Monde. When Paula left, she took my dog. I never saw her again except in court during the custody battle. She won and got to keep the dog, and I didn't speak to anyone for months. You know, sometimes it feels like there's so much that you need. Sometimes the world is upside down. Sometimes it seems like the only thing you need is holding someone's hand as you walk through town. I started hanging around with Dino. He used to run a poker game back east. Now he has a little coffee shop. Serves cappuccino to his old pals, Tommy Chicago and Jimmy the Wig and Ugly Rose. You know, the best person I ever knew was a Mormon woman named Estelle. She still calls me drunk every few months and asks me stuff I don't want to talk about. You can't talk to her long unless you're drunk yourself, and we go all night. Back on love. You had so many chances. Why have you let them all go by? Well, one morning I was sitting out front of Dino's place with Jake the Shears, a guy from Philly who gives free mohawks. There were a couple of young painters I was hoping to come by so I could give them some advice. Yeah, I was sitting there updating my list of enemies when this girl walks in and the universe kind of stopped. Turned out she drank the same tea as me. Don't take more than that to start a conversation sometimes. She believed collage was the greatest of all the arts and was busy pasting pictures of horses next to ads for laundry soap next to Muhammad Ali. She had a turquoise in her ear and said Rachmaninoff was always in her hand. Later that day I was trying to describe her Jimmy the Wig. I couldn't find any words and I realized I'd started to sketch her chin. Somehow it didn't look right. I scratched it out and tried it again. I filled an entire pan. I threw it away. I never even came close. For 6 days I sat at Dino's place. The rain wouldn't quit and no one came in. Finally on the seventh day it cleared and in she walked. I asked her to sit with me and I bought her a cup of tea. And I asked her to model for me sometime. That afternoon I was at a canvas. She was wearing a yellow dress. I swore if she'd let me I'd get it right. I painted over 10,000 paintings. Sad ones, funny ones, dark ones, and light ones. But sitting there was like I couldn't even write my own name. I apologized and said it's been a few months. If you have patience, I'll get the hang of it again. In the next few weeks, I've painted her hundreds of times. If I get my nose right, the chin's too long. If I get them both right, the face is too thin. But I keep after it, and one day I'll get it all right. I painted a still life this morning.
But throat lies and sitting on a copy of Tropic of Cancer. The only thing that's funny is I never thought I'd paint anything again. I think I might go visit Estelle. Those Utah mountains are good for the soul. I'll bring my brushes and some Jack Daniels and we can make up for lost time. She said, why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why have you turned your back on love? You had so many chances, why have you let them all go by? She said, why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why have you turned your back on love? You had so many chances, why have you let them all go by? Sometimes it seems like there's so